start right away. I would like to give you first an introduction to research data management in general, what you need to consider, why it is important, and also how you could approach the project and do it. The second part will be about GFBio and the services we provide all along the research data lifecycle. And in the end, you have the possibility to ask questions and we can discuss about certain things you're interested in. They also asked, have you failed to reproduce an experiment? And they asked, have you failed someone else's experiment, which is the dark rat? And have you failed to reproduce your own experiment? And this is quite surprising. Almost 60% said yes, they failed to reproduce their own experiments. You have to provide a data management plan in your proposal, stating how you deal with your data, how you long-term archive them, and also about open access, if and where you want to publish your data. Well, to anticipate the answer a little bit, you should do it according to the FAIR data principles. So, let's get a bit more serious again. A data management plan is a formal document outlining what you do with your data during and after your project. The next reason is that some funding agencies require you to write a data management plan, as in DFG, for example. And it could actually also happen that your proposal is rejected because you don't provide a proper data management plan. Just a few words on file organization and naming conventions. Keep your file short, that's 32 characters, and use descriptive names. So the next step would be to actually describe your data in a way that others and machines can understand it. And I think this is a quite nice example. When it comes to preservation is really long-term and it aims at the integrity of the data. Preservation or long-term archival is usually done by curated data repositories.
Yes, please. Why shouldn't you store it on a USB drive?
Yeah, that's a good question. Of course, you can store your data on a USB drive for, let's say, a short time, but the lifetime of a USB stick is not very long, and it's not very safe. Of course, you can lose it easily, and it's a small, tiny thing. And what publishing data actually means, so it doesn't necessarily mean that you only have an Excel file in your appendices of your publication, because of course Excel files are not really reusable or only to a certain extent, and maybe there might be some problems like with the variables and explaining those variables and things like that. So publishing data is really publishing the actual data set in a trusted repository. You don't have to do it all right away in the beginning, but start with small things like thinking about your file structure and your folder organization. Keep doing that and kind of try to integrate it in your daily routines, because otherwise it just wouldn't work out in the long run. And so spending a little time up front might really save you a lot of time later on. Thank you. Create a G5 account and explore with your own data, and I hope you liked it.